Ladies and gentlemen, it is time. What is going on, Dragon Ball fans? Welcome back to another episode of Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 Mods, introducing the Mastered Ultra Instinct Vegito Challenge. Now, in case you guys are unaware, this is pretty much a challenge to where we're going to be fighting some of the most powerful characters in the game. Of course, randomly, I will select a few people that I want to go on ahead and test the waters with early on. So without wasting any more time, this is Mastered UI Vegito, created by my boy Itsenzu, and a lot of you guys wanted me to kick off the series using somebody strong, so Vegito now, as you guys can see based on his stats, is incredibly powerful. So without wasting any more time, let us go on ahead and begin. So Vegito's first opponent is going to be someone random. Who's it going to be? We're about to find out in a few seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, bam. Okay, wow, okay. So, the Universe 12 God of Destruction Gene. Now, this is going to be most interesting because I've always wanted to see this god in action. And, I mean, this would be very interesting. Even though Vegito, I think, would just stomp a mud hole in Gene. Let me know down below as to what you guys think. And again, if you guys are new to this channel, don't forget to punch that subscribe button, guys. Turn on notifications. That's always very important because that way you guys can be notified whenever a brand new video is posted. Also, if you guys want to watch more mods from me, you guys can find the mods down below. I will leave a link down below in the form of a description link. That way you guys can click on that and enjoy. Let me see if I can defeat this dude. Damn. Okay, so obviously it looks like both of us have UI. This is crazy. I really don't think I can touch this dude. That's gonna be a problem. Hold on. This is going to be a problem because I'm not entirely sure if I can hit this dude. Let me see. Spirit stab. Okay, this is bad. This is very bad for obvious reasons. I wanna see, hold on. If I don't get any hit on this dude, that's gonna be, oh, hold on. I have to get something on this. Oh, there we go, finally. Alright, so Vegito has the upper hand. I was about to say, man, if I don't get any hit on this guy, we're gonna lose. But of course, right now we have the upper hand. Stab this dude real quick. Oh shit, come on. If he recovers, we are fucked. That's why we can't afford for him. Ah, he recovered, damn. Alright, obviously you guys can tell that his stamina is beginning to break every single time I do that. Let me see. Actually, I have an idea. I just noticed it, by the way, too. So the spirit stab may actually serve its advantage in the idea that the more I use this, the more stamina it takes away from him. So hopefully enough, I can take away as much stamina as I have to. That way I can just lower his health, let me see here. But as I said before, guys, let me know down below, how strong would a Mastered UI Vegito even be? And the reason why I ask you guys this is because it's very interesting to me in seeing such a concept like this, because Vegito at this stage in the game, I believe, would be incredibly powerful. Most definitely way more powerful than a god. Some people may disagree with that. Some people may say, well, we don't really know as to how strong the other gods are, and that's very true. However, in this case, we have two Mastered Ultra Instincts, you know, combining their powers, so I think that it's only natural for them to be even above a Hakaishin. Damn, dude. Alright, hold on. Gene looks like he's gonna be... Yo, he's gonna kick my ass real quick. Oh boy, I have to continuously back up. Let me see if I can just go on ahead and just issue an ass whooping on this dude right now. I can't seem to catch him. That's the problem here. I really can't seem to catch this guy. Then again, I will say this. Let me see. I want to go ahead and try something. Hold on. We have about 46 seconds remaining. Oh boy. Hold on. This might be my only chance to do something that can just break right through his stamina. Because really, that's all I'm trying to do right now, is break right through his stamina. And with only 30 seconds remaining, I don't know if I can do that. Let me see. Oh, wait. This might be my only window of opportunity right now, guys. Hold on, watch this. Oh, shit, he got me. Hold on, folks, hold on. Oh, he's gonna win. If I don't do something right now to break his stamina... Oh, shit. There we go, yes. Okay, now we're in the lead. Now we're gonna be in the lead because now I have the advantage. There goes his health. Now, I'm gonna win based on decision, even though I want to finish him off via stabbing him to death. Let me see here. Hold on, guys. Hold on. Oh, his stamina recovered. Shit. Okay, fair play to Jin. Fair play to Jin. But you know what it is? I think that there wouldn't even be any competition with this, considering how strong someone like Vegito would actually be. So, once again, guys, comment down below as to the next survival challenge you guys want me to do. For this one, I might choose the entire shirtless Vegito. So, let's see. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna fight Frost? Really? Nah. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Gohan? Nah. I mean, these are considerable characters that we already have in the game. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ooh, okay. We have Gokan. We have Kaioshin Gokan. Okay. That I think, in my opinion, that can be a that could be a good fight, because he has the ability to transform into a Super Saiyan Blue as well. But also, guys, I do want to say I do have lots of things planned for Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi 3. In case you guys have missed out on that, check out that playlist. I also have stuff you know, ready for Dragon Ball What If, you know, discussions and stuff like that. So all I have to say to that is make sure you guys are just continuously tuning in on the channel, because I do have stuff planned daily. And although Dragon Ball Super is over, it's still very interesting to me, at least, to see what the community has to offer in the next couple of weeks, in the next couple of months. I am going to continue the Dragon Ball Q&A session, all that good jazz, especially Xenoverse 2 and the Dragon Ball games, because obviously you guys may already know, I just love playing the game so much, because the mod community tends to create some really dope shit. Oh, what the f- damn, Vegito, that was crazy. What in the world was that? Yo, I don't ever reckon using that move. Damn, look at the power from this dude right now. Holy crap. Yeah, Gokan doesn't stand a chance. However, you know, Ultimate Gohan and Goku's fusion, that would be incredibly OP if you ask me. Hold on, you know what? Use the Divine Rush. Aw, that sucked. I wasn't able to do anything. Hold on. I want to see if I can inflict enough damage to where I can actually use the Ultra Rush attack. If anything. If not, then that's fine. But yeah, I promise you guys right now, Gokan is finished. Hold on, hold on. Oh, did we get him? Yeah, we got him. We got him. Vegito going in for the kill. All right, so far we are 2-0, so that's essentially a good thing. We beat Jin via decision, and we beat Gokan via knockout. So, and again, I really hope you guys tune in for the entire video, because we have so much to showcase. So let's go ahead and pick opponent number 3. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Who is this? Oh, Kefla. Yo, everybody always talks about Kefla's potential, and as strong as Kefla is, or at least once was, I really wouldn't rule out the idea of her reaching Super Saiyan 3, because imagine if Kefla actually was able to reach Super Saiyan 3. That would be inconceivable in terms of a concept. However, our boy Master UI Vegito would completely shit stomp her, no problem. So once again, she was actually created by It's Senzu as well. So Senzu, hopefully enough, he didn't create, you know, a monster right now, because he created a monster with Vegito, but with Kefla, let me see. Oh, hold on. Can I beat her ass? There we go. Nice. Oh, damn. All right, she caught me with that one. Let me see. I want to see if I can outmaneuver her. There we go. Yo, there's no way she can even remotely stand a chance against me right now. I am just kicking her in the hiney all over the place. But let me know down below, I did this based on your requests on Snapchat, on Twitter, and I asked you guys in the previous videos as to what you guys wanted to see in terms of survival challenges and stuff. And, you know, a lot of you guys voted for Vegito. And obviously, for obvious intents and purposes, I mean, this version of Vegito is absolutely amazing. I've seen other variations of Vegito before, and I do have other mods that I have not showcased yet, which I'm really hoping to showcase one day. Oh, the Divine Kamehameha. Oh my god, we got her with the attack too. Wow. Yo, we finished her off with the Divine Kamehameha. The Ultra Instinct Kamehameha from a fusion too. Honestly, I'm not sure if, you know, if such a fusion would last very long, because considering his overwhelming power and whatnot. So let's do Shirtless Vegito versus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ooh, we have Omni Zamasu. Now, honestly speaking, the one quality about Zamasu that made him so unique was the fact that he was immortal. Now, the question is, what if this was, you know, the Omni King fused with Zamasu, or at least, you know, Zamasu taking over his essence in fighting a mastered UI Vegito? Then how would the fight go? Like, you know what I'm saying? Because with that being said, you're fighting someone that can't die. So would a mastered Ultra Instinct Vegito be able to kill an Omni-merged Zamasu? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I really wouldn't rule out the idea of Omni Zamasu erasing Vegito, but I mean, damn. Alright, let's see here. And Omni Zamasu was, he was one of my favorite in terms of, like, designs in Xenoverse 2, because, like, just the way he looks, his presence is just amazing. Let me see if I can beat his ass. He has all the universes on his back, and that's what I think makes him so unique, I think. Oh, man, yo, Zamasu stands no chance right now. Damn, dude, Zamasu is getting tortured right now. Oh, did you just see that? Yo, did y'all just see that? That was nuts. That was pretty insane. Because all you saw was like a back and forth between the two. Oh, Kamehameha right to the back. See, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. Oh my god, Vegito is torturing this man. How is this even fair right now? This is not even fair. This is just sad, because Zamasu has no chance. He blocked. Wow, okay, hold on. Wow, so Vegito with he crushed his back. He must have crushed his spinal. Yo, that's crazy, man. Okay, so another victory under UI Vegito's belt. Okay. Again, this is what makes Vegito so awesome in the game. His ability to move and everything. So, shirtless Vegito versus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, I don't want to fight any of the in-game models. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, okay. Imperfect Ultra Instinct Vegito versus Mastered Ultra Instinct Vegito. Okay, I mean, honestly speaking, the obvious is going to win. But the only thing is, I'm fighting myself. So I'm not entirely sure if I'm able to do everything that I need to do to lower his stamina enough. But we're going to try either way. So, hold on. I got the first hit on him, which means I'm in the lead right now. So as long as I can keep this up right now, we should be fine. Because remember, he is me right now. Look at that. He's me. He's essentially me right now. Oh crap. Hold on. Oh shit. There we go. I had him for a second. All right, hold on. Hold on, folks. I had him for a split second, so I want to see if I can continuously do the same thing. Let me see. There we go. So much for him being in control right now, right, guys? But, this is what makes the mod community so awesome, is the fact that the mod community is able to do so much. Oh, crap. I completely forgot he's able to do the exact same thing I can. You know, let me see. I wanted to use the Divine Kamehameha. Oh, no. The Divine Kamehameha, but this is a problem. This is a problem now, folks. Oh, this is a problem. This is going to be a problem. Hold on. He's coming after me. He's strong, dude. He's strong. Let me see. Damn it. Yo, this dude, bro. Let me see. Divine Kamehameha. And bam. Did it work? Oh, my God. It barely fucking worked. Oh, no, dude. That barely freaking... Oh, there we go. Okay, cool. So now all I need to do is just stay in control, because there's no way he can outmaneuver me right now. His stamina is low, and let me see if I can just continuously do this. Let me just stab him in the face. There we go. Oh, hell yeah. We're going to win this. Oh, we're going to win. Yes, we connected too. Nice. Damn, Master UI is a beast, man. Now, if you guys personally believe that there's anybody else that can hold a candle to somebody like, you know, Master UI Vegito, let me know in the comment section below as to who you guys think that is. So we're going to use Shirtless Vegito to fight the following. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Damn it, I don't want to fight Nuova or Ice, bro. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, definitely not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ooh, yes. All right, so this is merged Zamasu with Vegeta Absorb. So this is pretty much Zamasu and Vegeta Black. I mean, just in case those two were to have like some sort of like a unholy fusion, this is what they would end up looking like. So we're going to fight above Earth. But either way, guys, I do want to say thank you all so much for watching. If you guys are still watching up until this point, I want you guys to hashtag regulars in the comment section. Also, thank you all so much for continuously supporting the channel. We are almost at 500,000 subscribers, guys. Let's see if we can get there together. The only way to get there is to, you know, help spread the word about the channel. Try to get the word out there about the channel, sharing it to your friends, to your family. Share the channel on Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, wherever you guys deem fit. And let's try to see if we can hit that goal very soon, actually. Yo, let me see if I can beat Zamasu's ass. Yo, the thing about this game and all of its updates and stuff, it gives me hope for something like Xenoverse 3. Because Xenoverse 3, believe it or not, when it comes out, it's going to be absolutely amazing to see, like, what they're going to be doing in terms of story concepts, in terms of, like, its online play. Like, you know, like, the one thing I really do hope they remove is the shitty timer that we have here. Because this timer is god-awful. Like, it has to be one of the worst things in the game. And it makes the game that much more less enjoyable, because you already know you have to rely on a stupid timer to get the job. It's done for him. Damn, Vegito. Damn, and not only did we break his stamina, yo, Vegito is basically unbeatable. Yo, this dude is unbeatable. The only other person I would say gave me a good fight was Jin. Jin was the only one. Alright, so we're gonna use UI Vegito again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Who is this? Oh, Cell X. Okay. Okay, now the reason why this is going to be most interesting is because Cell X... first of all, he's one of the most awesome characters I've seen in the game in terms of its design, but I also want to see what he has to offer in terms of value. So, let us begin this shit. Look at the size of this fucking dude, holy crap. Alright, so Let me begin to charge up my stamina, my power. Stamina's already charged. I don't know why I just said that. Hold on, let me see. Alright, so you just stay right there. You stay right there, big boy. I'm about to stab you. Hold on. About to stab you again. There we go. Alright, Cell, I guarantee you, this one attack is going to end it all. I guarantee you. Watch this. Oh, he's alive. Not anymore. Stabbed him, too. Wow. Damn. That was too easy. That was so freaking easy, dude. Damn. Okay, Ultra Instinct Vegito wins. Yo, I haven't done a survival challenge in ages, and I think this alone is just like, this is too much. Let me see. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ooh, okay, we have another version of Limit Break Vegito, or this is supposed to be Ultra Instinct Vegito. So let me see if I can go on ahead and fight him. Let's fight in the open field. This has been one of the maps that I hardly ever used, but this mod was created before the official name of Ultra Instinct was created, so that's the irony in this fight here. Let's do this, Vegito. Yo, this other dude is fucked. This other dude is fucked because he doesn't have UI, so that's what's gonna be the deciding factor for this fight right now. Watch this. I told you guys, look at this. Look at the ass whooping, bro. Not even close. Oh, he stabbed me. Okay. Okay. I mean, is his attacks high? I have no idea. Maybe it's his spirit sword that really fucked me up. Damn. And I'm not gonna lie to you guys, this map is pretty cool too. What I really cannot wait for is I cannot wait for more DLC for the game in terms of like open maps and like stuff like that, because I'm pretty certain that the game has more planned. Yo, this is nuts right now, dude. This is absolutely crazy. Let me see if I can use my Ultra Rush. Can I do that? Oh, he moved out the way. Let me see. Oh, we got him. We punched him right in the nutsack. That's what ensured our victory right now. Alright, so damn, UI Vegito is just cleaning house. Alright, so before we end up going here, what I want to do is showcase UI Vegito once more. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Definitely not Frieza. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Helice, I don't know. I mean, I feel like this is going to be a slaughter, but you know what? The Universe 2 God of Destruction. Let's go on ahead and fight at the Champa Tournament, the Nameless Planet. Either way, guys, I do want to say once again, thank you all so much for watching. If you guys want to watch more mods from me, you guys can click the description box and you guys can find the link to all of the Xenoverse 2 mods. You know what I'm going to do? Watch this. I'm going to let her swing. Look at this, man. She can swing all she wants. At the end of the day... Oh, okay, never mind. I ended up blocking that one because I thought I was in control. All right, Helice, come here. Come here, Helice. Can I grab her by any chance? Yeah, she's finished. She's finished. And what's... I mean, her universe to me was most annoying because of Rebrianne, but I think the most underutilized universe was definitely Kitella. Kitella was so dumb. His universe was ass, man. He had like one of the worst universes ever. Because he was trash talking. He had, you know, Ganos and all these ass monkeys and stuff. And we had Roshi fodder, 4 of them. So it was so dumb to see that. Like, you know what I'm saying? But Helice right now, yo, I want to give her a fighting chance, but I want to see what she can do. Let me see. Because right now, I am just decimating her. Hold on. Let me see. I'm going to leave her right here. Okay, hold on. Come on, Helice. I want to lower her health enough so I can hit her with my Divine Kamehameha. If I can hit her with my Divine Kamehameha, oh crap. If I can hit her with the Divine Kamehameha, I think we should be fine. That's only if actually I break her, I end up breaking her stamina. Oh, wow, I didn't mean to back elbow her, bro. Holy crap. I wanted to break her stamina and then use the Divine Kamehameha, but I guess that works as well. Either way, everybody, thank you all so much for watching. Vegito is a beast. I might end up doing part 2 if you guys want me to do part 2. Again, this was randomly selected, so if you guys want me to manually select next time, just let me know down below. Thank you all so much for watching, guys. Once again, tune back in for more. Let me know down below as to who you guys want to see for the next survival challenge, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Thank you all for watching, guys. Cue my outro, bitch.